Today, I'm going to talk about running in a face mask. Miles, 8 minutes, 36 seconds per mile, 139 beats per minute on average today for my run. Going out there running in a face mask, which is something that I've been doing regularly now. For those of you who are new here to the channel, my name is Kofuzi and I'm a non-elite runner out of Chicago. And I have been running in a face mask lately, which is not really all that new of a thing for me as someone that runs all winter long in a place that has a real winter, like in Chicago. But I've also been getting a lot of questions lately about people who are interested in running in face coverings, whether they're neck gaiters like this one or whether they're face masks. So I thought I'd put this video together. Now, if you don't think that you need to wear a mask or you think it's somehow emasculine or un-American or communists or something like that to wear a mask or whatever your reason is, or you don't think it's necessary to wear a mask, that's cool. This isn't the video for you. I would appreciate it if you didn't watch the rest of this video because it's not meant for you. So if you want to talk about whether or not we need to be wearing masks or debate that, there's lots of places on the internet for that. That isn't here. For those of you who are curious about whether you want to wear a mask, like what's it like, that's what this video is about. I'm not gonna try to convince anyone whether they need to do that or not. You can check out your own local authorities, your state authorities, and what your country is telling you in terms of what you need to do, both from a disease control perspective or from a governmental perspective. So that's on you guys. You guys do what you want to do. But if you're curious, here's the different types of face coverings that my wife and I have experienced and the ones that I've personally run in. So the first is going to be a neck gaiter. And essentially what it is a tube of fabric that goes around your neck. And if you want to, you can wear them a variety of ways. When it comes to covering your face, the way I run all winter long, because your face gets cold when it's below freezing and you're out running, is you pull it up over the front of your face so it covers kind of like a face mask would. And then I also pull up the back part of it too a little bit higher. So I got this up here, comes over the ears a little bit, and then it comes over your face. And this is what it looks like. And this particular one is double layered, so it's a little bit thicker. So it's a little bit harder to breathe in. Most of the neck gaiters that I have are single layer, so they're a lot easier to breathe in, but there's also less material that you're breathing through if that's something that you're concerned about. I haven't been all that concerned about it. I've been running in both masks and in neck gaiters, but usually these are things that I wear in the winter time, and I usually wear a winter cap over it so that I can really pull this high up in the back over the back part of my head, like this high. That way it just stays on a little bit better, and then the winter hat comes up top. When I'm wearing a ball cap like this, they're a little bit harder to wear, so I've been looking for something else to try and run in to keep my face covered as the months start to get a little bit warmer. The other thing is, this does cover your entire neck. In fact, I've been using these instead of scarves all winter long and for a while now because I just prefer them. I think they're easier to wear than scarves. I lose them less often than scarves, and they tend to be warmer than scarves. So that's something that I like because of the fact that they cover the back of the neck, but that also makes it hot for this time of year. So here's six other different types of face masks that I've seen on the internet, whether it's in Instagram ads or just looking around doing searches for other masks that you can buy. A lot of like local dry cleaners and other places that do like hemming and tailoring and sewing have also been making them. So I see signs in the neighborhood all the time of people that'll make them for you. And so I think I'll go over them. I'll just kind of go down the line. This is the first kind that I'll talk about is my favorite kind. It's very different from the other ones that I've seen. And this one looks a little bit different in that it kind of like cups to the face a little bit. I call it like a saddle style because it looks like it's curled up a little bit in the front. These get put on a little bit differently. Rather than hooking over the back of the ears, these go over your head. So you put them over your head, a little bit awkward since I left my hat on, but I'll put them down and then I'll pull them back up. And so then it fits. So this strap goes up top, kind of over the visor of the hat. And this stays down low. This tends to fit my face really well. It makes a nice little pocket inside where my mouth is, where I'm breathing. Comes down nicely underneath the chin as well. So everything feels really nice and snug. This is my favorite kind of fit in terms of the shape of the face mask. Really great to run in. I run easy paces in these and harder paces in these, and it seems to be fine. This is a double layer one. Some of them are built with even more than that, or might have pockets that you could put in a filter. This particular one doesn't. I also like the fact that the elastic is really thin. I like the thinner elastic better. I'll talk about that a little bit more when we get to some of the face masks with thicker headbands. So then when you take it off, everything comes back off. This one's harder to take off cleanly. I know that for people that are really concerned about like germ and contamination, when you're taking these things off, you want to be really careful that you're not like accidentally rubbing the outside on your face. So that's something you want to be careful of. This one and this style is a little bit more difficult to take off. The next one that I'll talk about is this one my wife bought. It's got like a little bit of a Star Wars pattern to the fabric. Two main things going on with this one, or three main things. One is it's pleated. The pleats are nice because then when they go over your face, it stretches just kind of like the paper disposable masks will. So they stretch and conform to your face really nicely. This one also has a pocket inside that's been sewn in there. It's two layers of, just basically a layer of cotton that otherwise folds over. So if you don't put a filter in there, you're getting a dual layer of like cloth protection. So that's nice as an option. I haven't been running with any filters in, and I haven't been really using any of the filters when I'm walking around the neighborhood. Trying to limit my time outside that's not exercising or walking the dog. These days, now that we've gotten masks for the kids, some of the Etsy sellers that we've gone to do make smaller ones intended for children. So we have been letting them go take the bikes outside just around the block to get some exercise. So when I do use these though, the thing I don't like about them is the ties. I thought that I would appreciate the ties much more, but I find them harder to use. They're harder to put on. They're easy, relatively easy to take off, but harder to put on. And that's because you have to tie them like back behind your head and it's hard to see. The other thing is this particular tie has these like little frilly things on the end, and it makes it so that it catches easily. And so when I try to untie it and like pull on my knot, like the bow that I've made to like untie it, it catches and then it gets into a knot that I have to like basically loosen it and get this off my face and then untie them. So I always have problems with this one. I like the design, I like the fit, I just don't like these ties. And I think a lot of the early masks that were coming out had ties on them because there was like a temporary elastic shortage. So that was like a big deal. The next one that I'll talk about that is my favorite is this particular one for a couple of reasons. This one came from an Etsy seller in Hawaii. My wife picked this one out. The outside is kind of like a thicker, almost denim type material. The inside is just regular cotton, so it's dual layer. It's navy, not black, because this particular Etsy seller was out of black. So my wife got navy for us instead. What I really like about this one is as the thinner elastic, which I like because it loops around the ears really well. It's got pleats up front so you can really mold it to the shape of your face. And this has a little bit of like something flexible in there so I can kind of pinch it down over my nose. So I'm getting a nice fit. This is my favorite one. Easy paces in this were fine. Harder paces. When I got to harder paces, I think because this outer material was a little bit thicker, then I started really feeling it in my breathing. But otherwise, I was able to run just fine in this one. I'll talk about another one that's similar to that, which is this one here that I ordered on an Instagram ad. And the one that's different about this one, it's a very soft, almost like t-shirt material. And on the bottom, there is an area, or I guess it's the top. There's an area where you can put in a filter. So there's a pocket in here. So you could do that. It's really nice and soft. The elastic is a medium kind of thickness and stretchiness elastic. It goes over the ears really well and has some pleats. Because it is the really soft material, the pleats aren't as like well fitting over the face. So I feel like it's just kind of covering me like a neck gaiter would cover me. But I like this one. It's easy to breathe through because it is a thinner material, and it's been comfortable for me. So this is one that I've been liking. The nice thing about this one is, and I've seen a lot of companies doing similar, like it was like $5 for $25, which I felt like was a pretty good price. And in addition to getting me 5, they donated 5 to some other kind of like first responder level people, not people that are needing it from a medical perspective, but people that are working at essential jobs that need to wear masks. So I thought that was nice. So that's a good one to have, but like, because it's so soft, it doesn't have quite as much structure on it. So I think it looks a little bit sloppy, but I think it feels fine. Here's the one that I like the least of the ones that my wife has purchased. This elastic is nice on here, but the size is a little bit shorter. It's not as tall as you can see comparing it to like this one, which I do like. So the height is a little bit different, but I think this one is one of my wife's favorite because she has a smaller face than I do. So while it does fit me, I feel like I'm really stretching it out to get it to fit. But when my wife wears it, it seems to fit her face fine. Some of these other ones, like the last two that I showed you, when my wife wears those, it looks like she's just got her whole face, like there's just so much covering going on her face, which maybe is a good thing. But I have a little bit of a larger head, and this one's a little bit small for me. So just be aware of some of the sizes. The ones that look really wide versus tall are probably gonna fit a little bit smaller. Now, the last thing that I'll talk about is one that I've been seeing a lot of lately. A lot of places are coming up with this kind of design where it's almost like a trapezoid. No pleat, but a thinner, stretchier material. This is a dual layer of a very thin, stretchy material that's on here. And there's a nice, robust piece of elastic on the sides. And while I would think that that would be my favorite kind, the reason why I don't like this one so much is because the stronger the elastic, the more it tugs on my ears. So I'll put this on here and I'll get it on. It fits my face relatively well, but it is a really thin piece of material that's on here, even though there's two layers. So this is probably the most breathable of all the ones. This one I got from Threadless, and they've been working with a variety of different artists. So if you have a favorite artist, there's probably a face mask that you can get that's by them. That's what I did here. But you can already see it's like tugging at my ears, right? And so that makes it a little bit uncomfortable. And sometimes it's a matter of like getting it really nicely and stretched on and making the fit is really like in the right spot, right in the crevice where your ear meets your head, to get it to stay on. So it takes a little bit more thought. But what I did find was towards the end of my run, I felt like this, as my head was getting sweaty, it was starting to slip even more. So I was worried that it was gonna come off while I was running. But it's also probably the one, if you have a regular size head, it's probably not a big deal. I have a bigger head. But the other thing is, if you're worried about breathability, this one's probably the most breathable of all the ones that I run in. So those are 6 different styles. I'll post links to some of them, to the ones that I still have. But a lot of the Etsy sellers are getting overwhelmed because lots of people are making orders. But I wanted to go over kind of like some different types of face masks, so that way if you're seeing another Etsy seller, you can kind of look at it and figure out like, you know, what style is the kind that you want to run in. So hopefully that was helpful. I'm sorry that we live in a world that I have to make this video. Not that I had to make this video, but I'm sorry that we live in a world that this kind of video is being made. It's sad, but these are some of the things that I've been living with, just, you know, in my building. I live in an elevator building, and sometimes there's lots of people, not a lot of people, but people in tighter spaces than I'd prefer. So we have masks whenever we leave our apartment, and I've been running in them just because I feel better about it. So that's kind of this lay of the land here. And if you have any questions, I'm happy to take them down below. If you want to tell me about how dumb I am, great. That's awesome. You probably won't get a response because I'm just going to move on. That's all I have for today's video. Thanks so much for making it all the way to the end. Hope you guys are staying safe however you guys are running, and I will see you guys in the next one. Yo, what's going on?